Wherever you want. So we're here at the John Labatt Centre with our gracious host, the London Knights, and Mr. Rocky Balboa, a.k.a. Mr. Harding on Twitter. And I'm here with LeafsFan71. Just going to show you a couple of little quick things. We're in the bowels of the John Labatt Centre, and we're being treated like VIPs. We're getting to see where everything happens in the backgrounds of a hockey game. And here we go. Oh boy, it's dark. I'm scared. All right. Where to next? Okay.
This is our main concourse.
All right. This is usually filled up with people drinking, people cheering every time the London scores a goal, kids running around, excitement. And wow, this is
all brand new. We just did this summer.
Look at this.
This is called the Freedom 55 Club Lounge.
Freedom 55 Club Lounge. This is incredible. Look at this.
Flat screen TVs everywhere. We also have a projection TV. They'll project the game net for them.
That's incredible. So this is where your VIPs would normally hang out between periods?
Yeah, in between periods, yes.
So is this access for the entire public or just the VIPs?
Just the premium seating ticket holders.
Excellent.
The VIPs will hang out in the back with
this
us.
Is incredible. Now, any idea what this costs to renovate or to do these? To do this?
Probably close to $70,000.
That's fantastic. It's absolutely, you know what, from being at a lot of OHL arenas, this is one of the nicest setups I've seen. And it's not to disparage other arenas or whatever, but this is great.
Yeah, it's the envy of a lot of OHL arenas, it really is.
The thing I'm,
you put 9,090 people in here every game.
The thing I'm noticing the most about this place is, even though there's nobody here yet, because obviously the game's not for 5 hours, it's just how clean it is. It's absolutely spotless, immaculate. Now, how old is the John Labatt Centre?
It's 9 years old.
9 years old, that's it.
10th anniversary next October.
And how much did this arena cost when it was originally built?
$5 million.
And it seats?
9,090 for hockey.
9,090 for hockey?
Yeah.
And, David?
Yep.
Tell us how many people actually come to these games on an average.
It's a sellout every home game.
Every home game, guys, it's a sellout.
9,090 people.
So would you say that the London fans are the most loyal fans in the OHL?
Bar none, the most supportive.
So you support your team when they win or when they lose?
Win or lose.
Absolutely. So guys, you need to support your team, win or lose.
Wow. You have to.
9,090 fans.
I can't wait to see.
Now, LeafsFan71 goes to a lot of Marley's games. He's one of about 1,500 to 2,500 people that go to the game. So what he's telling you is that you should be more like the London Knights fans. Be loyal to your team, win or lose. Support them. Low-cost entertainment and a world-class facility. On with the tour.
We'll head over to the Knights retail. I think somebody wanted to get a sweater, didn't they?
Oh, yes. Got to have a London Knights jersey. Oh, man. How about those cars, too?
Lexus of London. One of our sponsors.
Lexus of London. These are gorgeous cars. There was probably, every game, there was at least probably 50 or 60 London Knights jerseys in the crowd. It was just sad because when I went to Memorial Cup, we were getting louder cheers from the Owen Sound fans than we were from the actual Majors fans. But I guess with 9,090 fans at the London games, I guess there's no chance of Erie drowning you guys out, hey?
No, I don't know if you've ever been to the Erie Arena.
No, not yet.
No, not worth the visit.
And you guys have everything here. The ice bucket sets.
Yep.
Lots of flat hats and the
covered hats.
The brim ones as well. Is that very good? And the fingers of doom. I love it. This is great. Now, when did this open up the same time the arena opened up, or was this a later addition?
No, it opened up the same time the building did.
And is your clothing done locally? The jackets and the hats, or?
A majority of it is done locally.
So, yeah, we use a lot of local companies for it.
Excellent. So you support your
local businesses.
Yep. That's good. I like that. You guys have a lot. Like I said, I buy stuff all the time at these shops, and you guys definitely have a wider collection of merchandise.
Yep.
I bought one of the big giant kazoos at the Majors game, and I tried to take it to a ACC game, and they confiscated it from me. But then again, you want your fans to be loud, right?
Yeah, you do.
Attaboy. This is just incredible. It's going to be great footage, too. Even better when they win. I was watching highlights of the game from last night. And
oh, you saw the scrum at the end?
Yeah, Max is a little feisty. It's like his dad, eh?
Yeah.
This is what I'm going to wear for Halloween next year, Alan. And now I think this is my jersey right up here.
NHL and the Knights jerseys.
Hey, Leaf fans. Remember this guy named Jeff Freeze? Or Bob Helkidis, bruising defenseman? This is the suite room. Private suite.
And what we do here, this is the, we sell a lot of these to minor hockey teams.
Okay.
A coach will bring the 20 kids or 40, you know, 20 kids, 20 adults. They'll have pizza. They'll put the air walls up to divide it. So there's your section for your kids. Or you can stand up here and watch the game, whatever you choose.
Wow. Or,
and they only charge them about $10 each.
So, Mr. Harding.
Yes. Uh-huh.
About $10 for these, for the group.
How long does it take to get a kind of suite like this?
Well, these are done through the group sales department.
Okay.
So it's
Are they all now? Are they all booked? Or are they all reserved?
No, they're not all booked. They're not all reserved.
Okay.
38 luxury suites are.
Luxury suites in an OHL hockey arena. Are you listening, guys? London fans really love their team. And if you look at the ice is crisp, very beautiful. Amazing seats, amazing view.
During the game, they have championship in 05.
So we're here with David Harding and Leafs Fan 71. We are in a special suite here at the JLC, the John Labatt Centre, home in London, Ontario, home of the great London Knights. We're in Ty Domi's personal suite. He's not here, otherwise he'd probably be kicking my butt for being in a suite, but that's okay. We're getting a special peek. And this is a bird's eye view where Ty can watch his son do what he does best. Again, flawless views from no matter where you are in the building. Absolutely flawless. Ty Domi's private suite. And here we have the kids coming out. And you have a special name for this, right, Mr. Harding? What do you call this?
It's called Rink of Dreams.
Rink of Dreams. And it allows kids to come out on the ice and play on a world-class facility and get an experience they might not ever get to have.
Yeah.
Top floor here at the JLC, John Labatt Centre, and this is the rowdy corner. This is where the most rowdy VIPs get to hang out and sit, sponsored by the Brick. And as you see, as we walk around this corner here, the Brick spared no expenses. Nice leather, soft leather seating. Doing it in style for the rowdy ones. So we're here at the very top of the JLC Center, John Labatt Center. And even from this very top view, the view is flawless. Still can see the ice, still can see the players. The reason they look small, by the way, these are little children. These aren't even teenagers. What a save by the goalie! And he freezes the puck. That's Ben Scrivens Jr. in nets, guys. Incredible. Just incredible. A rare look at an arena before game night.
This clock we just put in a year ago, August. It's brand new. It's a high-def video. Oh.
The scoreboard is put in August of this year.
August 2010.
Well, August 2010, sorry. And it's a high-def scoreboard. You can definitely tell it's...
In this December, we're putting in a ring. Where you see these ad panels now?
Right.
They're all coming out, and we're putting in a ring.
Like an LED ring?
Yep.
Fantastic.
Is that from the camera?
Yes.
Oh, this is the Zambonis.
Oh, that one?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead, Alan. And I get you on the...
Okay.
Get you in the Zamboni, and then I'll take a picture of you. Three Zambonis. Can I ask why you have three Zambonis?
No, there's only two.
What are these two? This one and that one.
Natural gas.
Oh, I thought this was a Zamboni here.
It is a Zamboni. Two Zambonis and low pressure natural gas.
Unbelievable. Alan, smile. Leafs Fan 71 on a Zamboni.
Can I take a picture of one of you guys run into a flood?
Oh, yeah. That's a freaking Lily. So we're here outside the John Labatt Centre, home of the London Knights. And I can tell you so far, I've been enjoying my tour. London is a world-class facility. JLC is mind-bogglingly modern, but at the same time, it still has a retro feel to it. So Marley's, if you're listening, go play in Maple Leaf Gardens. Stop playing at Rico. Beautiful, beautiful. And it's just an absolute gorgeous day in London. We're not wearing jackets because we're rednecks, but it's gorgeous out here. 7,000 parking spaces within a 2-block radius of the JLC. So people, you can't use the excuse, you can't find parking. And we're right across from the historic Covent Garden, home of the greatest outdoor market that's open 7 days a week during the summertime. And you would not believe some of the acts that have headlined here. Tom Jones, Cirque du Soleil, Nickelback, Cher, Bill Clinton's been here. The list goes on and on and on. JLC has seen it and done it. Coming up to the 10-year anniversary next year, you guys want to be there. Home of the London Knights. Attaboy. Suited up, I like that. That's great. Like, they should be. Like, I think it's great that they're doing the shirt and tie thing. Half of them look thirsty.
I don't recognize.
I know, because they're kids. So. Crowd here at the JLC. Leaf fans take notice, they're actually making noise. Marley's fans take notice, there's fans in the building. Greg McKay and Sondre Olden playing a very good game for Erie today. Unfortunately, nobody else is here for the Erie team, so they're going to be in big trouble. And my boy Vladdy with 2 goals already in this game. He's going to get the hat trick pretty soon. Probably this period. Tampa needs a goalie, so send Gustafson over to Tampa Bay and let us have Vladdy in Toronto. There you go, Brian Burke. Are you listening?
just going to